गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास 9, वेलकम टू इंग्लिश लिटरेचर पीरियड। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, यस्टरडे आई गेव समरी ऑफ दिस पोएम द स्नेक ट्राइब। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, व्हेनेवर वी टॉक about the snake, we have fearful feeling. Why? Because all the human beings, whenever they consider, they are afraid. Why? Because the snake is considered as fearsome symbol of death. But here we are going to know something different. There is a snake who is itself a victim. A victim. How? By reading the stanza, I want to give you explanation. You are seeing first stanza. The snake trying to escape the pursuing stick with sudden curving of thin long body. How beautiful and graceful are his shapes. He glides through the water away from the stroke. Oh, let him go over the water into the reeds to hide without hurt. In this poem, we have conveyed about a snake who is lying on a sandy ground very peacefully, but very silently, but all of a sudden he noticed a man with stick. Snake was afraid to be killed, to be beaten. So he tried to escape from the chasing stick. That snake was very beautiful, very graceful. Its shape was very beautiful, splendid, attractive, having thin, long body. See, the man, he begins to swim, begins to float over the water. How? From the stroke, from the force, from the attack. How does a snake creep, you know? How does a snake move forward? By twisting its body. While twisting, a force works. That force is useful to make the snake to move forward. or let him go over the water. First of all, the man having stick thought that the snake was harmless, innocent. He shouldn't hurt it. Without hurting, let it go. Without hurting, let it go. Where? How? Over the water. It means floating over the water into the reed. Reed, a type of plant having thick stem. Snake was small and green. Please notice, highlight these words, small and green. And in the first stanza, graceful, beautiful. Why did I tell you to underline these words? Because these words indicate, these words show, prove beauty of the snake. These words were used by the poet to describe snake's beauty. Snake was very harmless, innocent. Even he was harmless to the children. He couldn't give any type of harm to the children. Next, last stanza. Around last stanza, along the sand, he lay until observed and chased away, and now he vanishes in the ripples among the green slim reeds. Along the sand, on that sandy ground, snake was lying very silently until he was observed. He was seen by the man. And as soon as he noticed the man, he began to run. And all of sudden, he disappeared among the green slim reeds. Snake hid itself where? Among the reeds. Reeds, a type of plant having thick stems. Among them, the snake disappeared. Now, summary of this poem, question answer will be sent to you as PDF. You will write in your notebook, fair copy, not in practice copy. Thanks. Have a nice day.